Listen to that.
Really, really good to see.
Listen to that voice. Since we're going to see the movie, what's your vivid memory of making Vertigo?
Being with Jimmy Stewart, first of all, working with the genius Alfred Hitchcock, I must say that was just so special. Being away from Columbia Pictures and Harry Cohen, that was so special.
Was he that bad?
Oh, Harry Cohen?
Yeah.
Yes. That's pretty bad. Pardon me? Is it? Oh, okay. I'm sorry. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yes.
When Harry Cohen.
Sometimes I can't hear you. My hearing has gotten bad, so I might ask you to speak up, and you tell me if I need to speak up.
When Harry Cohen died, you mentioned him. When he died, George Jessel at his funeral.
Pardon me?
When Harry Cohen died, at his funeral, it was packed. It was packed. So many people, they had people outside. And someone asked George Jessel, why so many people? And he said, because they wanted to make sure. All right, so you're away from Harry Cohen.
Actually, when Harry Cohen died, part of me died too, actually, as Kim Novak. Because Harry Cohen, I might say, he was a bully, he was hard to be with, hard to be around. But Harry Cohen was a very special man, and I did miss him afterwards. I miss his talent, because he knew how to make movies. He knew how to make movies. And I truly missed him after he was gone. I, as Kim Novak, needed Harry Cohen, because he knew how to put a movie together. I fell apart when he died.
Why do you say as Kim Novak?
As Kim Novak, because he put my best movies together when he was alive.
You're two different people in this movie. Are you two different people in real life? You are.
I am, yes.
As Kim Novak then?
Oh, and as me? Well, yes, but that's a whole other story. Yes, because I'm bipolar, and so that's true. Yes, it is true. Yes, because Kim Novak and me are very definitely different.
Do you wish you were her?
What?
Do you wish you were her?
Which her do you mean? No, I'm not envious of Kim Novak, but sometimes. Yes.
Okay, back to Hitchcock. What was special about working for Hitchcock?
What
special about Hitchcock?
Oh, he was a genius. He knew everything about making movies. He did. I mean, he knew exactly what he wanted. When you got there, he knew what he wanted of you right away. It wasn't like some directors. He got there and he started, they would start scratching their head like, well, what are we going to do today? Many directors really didn't know. They would get there on the first day and didn't know what they wanted. But Alfred Hitchcock knew exactly. You knew him.
No, I never met him.
Yeah.
But I did know Jimmy Stewart. What was it like to work with him?
Jimmy Stewart? Yeah. Which do you want to know? Alfred Hitchcock or Jimmy Stewart?
Hitchcock.
Oh, my God. Well, all right. Jimmy Stewart, well, he was the best man I ever knew. My husband's here tonight. Jimmy Stewart was the most down-to-earth, real person that you ever want to meet. He was the man the man you wanted to live next door. You don't always live next door. The best man in the world, but he was the best person you ever want to meet.
Was Vertigo a difficult film to work in?
Yes.
You had to play two people.
It was, in a sense, because that director, as I said, who already wanted him. So that meant you had to be on your toes. You had to get up every morning and be ready to be.
That's the secret of the success of Cinema Dean.
Ten questions at the same time. I forgot Larry King. He knows. He's already on 10 questions.
No, I'm not Kim. Talk right into the mic.
Jimmy Stewart, the best friend you ever want to know, the sweetest, kindest man. And he's the kind of man, he lived, believe it or not, in Hollywood all his life. He lived in Beverly Hills on Roxbury Drive, and yet you'd never believe it because he was simple and honest and real, and you'd never believe he lived here all his life because he didn't want to live here all his life. He wanted the simple life. He always said, you did, just real and love to run on the beach and ride horses. You wanted this simple life.
Those last scenes in Vertigo.
Uh-oh, these jokes are not all over.
Not joking, I'm trying. Is that a difficult scene? Or that scare and all that? What did he say? Oh, they haven't seen the movie.
Oh, who hasn't seen the movie?
Everybody dies. Everybody falls, it's crazy.
He knows. That last scene, Alfred Hitchcock timed it with a metronome.
Really?
He did. Because he wanted that last scene. That's better. I don't live in Hollywood anymore. You have to train me all over again.
We're not giving anything away by telling you about the stairs because it's going to
How's that?
Up.
Is that better?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. I don't know about these things. By the end of the night, I'll be training and I go back to Oregon and I'll forget how to ride my horse.
Let's just a lot of things.
Oh, well, God, no. First, let me tell you. That metronome, he had it working.
Why did you leave the business at the height of your fame?
Because it was too complicated to turn the mic this way. Just know that they're going to come running up to me with the right script, and they're going to hand me some wonderful story at the right time, and everything's going to turn out just right. And they're going to hand me some beautiful story, and some wonderful actor's going to come along and say, I want Kim Novak to do this wonderful movie, and one of these days they're going to come and give me this beautiful script. And it didn't happen.
They didn't come.
It didn't happen.
That's shocking. Some other people.
Go ahead. I'm ready.
William Holden.
Oh, wonderful actor, wonderful actor.
That scene in Picnic.
Yeah.
That dancing.
Yeah.
What was that like?
You know, we just.
I know, I
did. Eric King and I both got here early. I'm never early in my life. But I was early tonight, and Larry was too, and he said, let's do that dance.
Yeah, but. I'm not William Holden. Come on. But that movie stuck with people forever. It's still, I told you it played on Turner Classic Movies a couple weeks ago. Was that fun to make?
That was wonderful. I'll tell you what I found that, what I think I did that was special is I brought reality. I mean, I think that I brought that small town reality and simplicity. I think that's what made me special, was that I was real, you know?
You were also damn sexy.
That's what made me sexy, was that I was honest and real.
Yeah, that you were. Okay, one of my friends. Dying to hear your thoughts, because you did two movies with him. You did The Man with the Golden Arm, and you did Pal Joey. Frank Sinatra.
Frank Sinatra was a wonderful actor to act with.
Why?
I mean, I think it's a combination with these different actors. And I think I brought out with them, again, the humanity that I brought, the reality, with these actors. We had a good thing together.
Did Sinatra make a move on you?
Of course he made a move.
You react to the move.
I was human. I was human. You know, he had blue eyes like you do.
I am brown. If you see him as blue, they're blue. Frank had beautiful eyes. He did.
Yeah.
No. Sinatra had beautiful eyes.
Your eyes were always very intense.
Thank you. But was Sinatra easy to work with? Because he didn't like to do a lot of takes. He didn't like to do a lot of takes, Sinatra. He liked it on the first shot.
I liked him on the first movie better than in the second.
I should bring your own
chest to him. You worked with him. He didn't like to do a lot of shots over and over.
Well, the first movie.
What was the first, Golden Arm?
The first movie I worked with was Man with the Golden Arm. And then the second movie I worked with him was Pal Joey. The second movie I worked with him, Pal Joey was a different character than he played. He played somebody that was.
Nightclub, show business.
Nightclub, mm-hmm. Show business. I guess I didn't care for the role he played. So he was very, I don't know, he just wasn't as nice in the second movie. You know, I mean, he was a kind of different kind of character.
Well, the Man with the Golden Arm, he was a drug addict. He was a drug addict, the Man with the Golden Arm. He was a drug addict.
In the first movie, he was a drug addict. And he was, I don't know, but we got along really good in the first movie.
Aha. Uh-huh. Okay, I'm going to ask you about someone else. One of my favorite actors, I never got to meet him. He died too young. Tron Power.
Mm.
Eddie Duchin.
I love that movie. It was wonderful. But Tyrone Power and I never got along.
Mm. You're kidding. He was madly in love with you in that movie. He was?
Yes. Yes. You know, the thing is, when I was a kid, I was in love with Tyrone Power. Mm. I mean, but I could never look him straight in the eye.
Why?
I was so in love with him, you know, that I couldn't, I mean, it was hard to look at him.
He was beautiful. He was very handsome. He was very handsome.
He was very, very handsome. I had such a crush on him. And I was embarrassed to look at him because, you know what I mean, when you have a crush on somebody and you're in love with him. And I had just gotten into Hollywood. And I think I was just...
But you didn't like him?
I did. I liked him too much.
You are, of course, an artist. You wanted to be an artist, an art major. We have some paintings we're going to show, right? So, and you tell us what we're going to look at, right? All right. As they say in the business, roll them.